Steve Dotto here. Our friends at Google have upgraded Gmail. They have incorporated some new features that are theoretically going to help us control our inbox more effectively. What they've done is they've taken the tabbed browsing concept. We're all very comfortable with tabbed web browsers. All of us now use one browser where we have all of our different tabs lined up along the top of the browser window. Well, they've taken that concept and they've applied it to email. That's the biggest change that they've done. But they've done some intelligent sorting of our email inbox to then slot our email into the appropriate tabs. I think we should dive in and I should show you. It may not be on your browser just yet as they're rolling it out in stages. I've got it in a fairly early release here. And if I go in and configure my inbox, this is where you have to go to see if you have the ability to do this. And everybody should have it very shortly. Once I choose configure my inbox, what they do is they've set up these 5 different tabs. You can't create your own at this point. You have to use their preset tabs. But they've sorted your email into main areas. Your primary email is for conversations, business that's ongoing, etc. Your social is for social networks, media sharing sites, etc. Now, as you look at this, and as if you click each one, what they do is they give you an example of the sort of people who they're going to slot into these different tabs as they kind of pre-sort or pre-wash all of your email. When you first look at it, you might start thinking, oh, I'm not too sure I want to have this stuff all sorted because I might miss important messages that are buried in one of the other tabs, especially if you just look at the primary tab, because the primary tab is where you're going to spend most of your time. That's a decision-making process you're going to have to work through yourself. I don't have any opinion one way or the other yet on that because I've just started to use it. One thing that you can do to control things a little bit more is you can include all of your starred messages in the primary. Now, Gmail really relies heavily on a starring system for delegating or designating what email is important. Once you say save, then there'll be a little brief reset while your browser window resets, and there it is. Now we see our different tabs. And did you notice that my email inbox, I'm a little overwhelmed with email right now. I had about 270 messages in my inbox because I've been on the road a lot lately. So I'm just now catching up on all of my email. But first I'm doing this video, which was number one on my list of priorities. Number two is going to be cleaning up my inbox. But you see, it went from 270 messages down to about 166 in my primary inbox. But my other inboxes, I have 26 emails in this one under the social ones, and it's all mainly LinkedIn, Google Plus, Pinterest, Twitter. It's got all of those different notifications are all there. And now, normally those clutter up your inbox. They aren't really usually crucial things, but they are things you like to monitor, so I can see them there. Promotions, these are different events that I'm going to be attending or people who are sending me out newsletters, that sort of stuff, and they all seem to be there. Now, you're going to want to go through each of these tabs when you first set it up, and you're going to want to take a look and make sure you're comfortable with what email is in each tab. If you see an email that's important, here's a workshop that I'm going to attend by my friend Mari Smith in just a few minutes from now, actually. If you think that that's important and should be in your primary email, you can just grab it and watch what happens when I drag it. See, I drag it, and I can move that conversation into my primary inbox. So you can organize what emails go into which inbox as you go through, and you can sort. Updates are, in this particular case, it's all the different software updates. I'm taking a look through, and I think this one here is going to be a little bit more confusing and kind of more of a mishmash of different information. And then the different forms, which has very little in it at this particular point. And as I sort things through, and that's more for conversations. I think that's more for discussion forums and that sort of stuff. But you're going to use it, and you're going to slowly get a feel for how tabbed email works for you. I'm not sold on it yet, but I'm also not negative on it yet. I think it gives us another option for organizing what's basically a fire hose of information flowing into a lot of our inboxes to creating a little more automatic structure for it. It doesn't seem to get in the way of all of the other different email tools that I have, and I've got a lot of different plugins installed, so it doesn't seem to get in the way of that. I'm not sure it's 100% going to work for me, but I'm going to give it a shot for a little while and see if it does work. I hope you found this. Oh, I should mention before I wrap up, which I was just about to do, that if you want to, look, you can just go back, and all you do to set your email back to the way it was is untick these four different tabs, and then you will just have your primary tab. So you can try it out with no commitment to it, and then you can set things back very easily to the way things were before. Now I'm going to wrap things up. I hope you found this video useful. If you have, please give us a like. We appreciate the compliments. I'm Steve Dotto, and we'll see you again very soon.